And going back to our earlier top story, we'll be talking now to former Health Secretary Esperanza Cabral about the revised RH bill. Dr. Cabral, magandang hapon po sa inyo.
Magandang hapon, Tony.
Mm-hmm. Would you say that the changes or revisions made to some of the provisions of the RH bill will still make the bill conform to its original objectives of providing proper reproductive health care for women?
Palagay ko ganun nga, Tony, because the essence of the RH bill are informed consent so that they can exercise their right to reproductive health at obligation ng government to provide reproductive health services to poor women who cannot afford it. And so far, I have not seen anything that contravenes these two principles of the reproductive health bill.
All right. So, from your point of view, it is something that can meet the objectives of the bill, and at the same time overcome the objections of critics of the bill who feel that it gives the government unwarranted power to control the choices of families as to how many children they will have, or to even set population targets and the like.
I think that it supports the principles of reproductive health and reproductive health rights. It does not give the government control over how many children a family should have. Mm. That is entirely the choice of the family.
Yes. It seems that many of the changes that have been put into this revised RH bill should already appease the critics. Do you feel that the critics may still have something to object to?
Well, I hope that it is going to be acceptable to enough of them so that we can pass the RH bill, because we cannot wait for more women to die every day while they give the RH bill.
Hmm. It's also very significant, I think, to note that when it comes to prescribing proper reproductive planning or reproductive health care, that the government will not insist on using devices or medicine that will, as it says, prevent the implantation of a fertilized ovum. Does this now rule out the use of any contraceptive devices like condoms, pills, IUDs, and the like?
Of course not. These contraceptives you mentioned all work by preventing fertilization, mm-hmm. not by preventing implantation. So they should be part of the menu of contraceptives available to women in the Philippines.
So there's a differentiation or a distinction between preventing fertilization and preventing the implantation of a fertilized ovum. But if these devices or medicines are still available, then necessarily at the beginning, the process that is prevented is the fertilization per se.
Yes, all of these are contraceptives. They prevent the meeting of the egg and the sperm.
Mm-hmm. And at that point, which is still something that the church finds objectionable, some of the pro-life people still find objectionable, that there should be no artificial contraceptives included in the bill.
Yes.
Is that, do you feel that that might still be a sticking point for the revised RH bill?
I think so, yes. I think some hardliners are going to insist that all methods of contraception, except not family planning, are actually methods of abortion. The entire false has been proven false by all scientific evidence that we have.
Mm. So it is of course, emphasized that the state is not promoting abortion through this RH bill. What it does emphasize is that families can have or can bring into this world children as long as they are raised in a humane way. But how do we make sure that these families, especially if we are prioritizing the low-income sector of society, that they can have the resources to raise children in a humane way?
Well, to help them is exactly by what the Reproductive Health Bill advocates, is to provide them with the correct information so that they can make intelligent choices. And if they cannot afford to buy their own contraceptive supplies or goods, then government will provide them.
Dr. Cabral, we've heard, of course, the some of the senators say that it's taken a long time, more than 10 years, for this bill to reach the stage in which it is in now. Do you think the time for debates, given the changes or the amendments to this RH bill, is finally over? Or do you still see more room for debates happening when Congress resumes sessions by November?
Well, as far as I'm concerned, the time for debate has long been over. But every individual legislator has his own mind. And if they want to obstruct the RH bill, even now that the proponents have bent over backwards to address their concerns, they can still do it.
All right. Dr. Cabral, we'd like to thank you for talking to us today. And thank you for being on Top Story with us.
Thank you very much, Tony. Good evening.